So, Jiro?
I was cleaning up and found this. This is a calling card, right? I read about it online, too.
You went into my room without my permission?
I'll apologize as much as you want later. So, what is this?
That's...
Is it something to get flustered over? I knew it. This isn't just some game you're playing. Why aren't you saying anything?
Why did you keep it? I mean, it was memorable.
Explain.
Explain.
Is it something that you can't explain?
Explain!
Hey, if this keeps up, Futaba's...
You will, huh? I'll get right to the point. Is this a real one? Was a change of heart triggered in you? How about it?
Ever since Mom died, there was no exit. I was trapped in a labyrinth of my heart. I knew I had to leave it, but I couldn't do it by myself.
Futaba. Here, sit down. I can at least listen to what you have to say.
The Phantom Thieves saved me. They stole my messed up heart. It's the same as Mom's research. They changed my cognition.
Seriously? Wakaba's research about altering one's cognition. I wondered about it myself, too. Still. When she said she was going to go to the beach out of nowhere, and even the doctors had thrown in the towel. At first, I just chalked it up as other kids being a better support for you than any adult. But as I kept watching the tabloid shows here day in and day out, a thought crossed my mind. I thought your case kind of seemed similar to what these Phantom Thieves were doing. I'm still your guardian, you know. I'd never overlook such a drastic change in your behavior.
So, Jiro.
But to think that Wakaba's research and the Phantom Thieves changing hearts were about the same thing. Back in the day, I used to be a government official. My job was to be the bridge between the country and the lab that Wakaba worked at. It's around that time that I got to know her. She said something odd when we were out drinking. That she might soon die in an odd way. Who wouldn't take that as a joke? I just laughed it off. But it happened exactly as she said. If anything were to happen to you, I'd feel like I let her down. There's something I want to ask you. Judging from your attitude, you knew about this calling card, didn't you? You should have known that Futaba had a change of heart through the Phantom Thieves as well. Is there a connection between you and them? The first incident of a change of heart was a teacher at your school. The kid who brought that painting here was a pupil of that artist who had a change of heart, wasn't he? And then, there's Futaba. These scandals always seem to find their way around you. What do you have to say? These people are called criminals by the general public. Why did you introduce such dangerous people to Futaba?
That's not true! I asked them! That's why he saved me! He stole my heart!
Asked? Stole? Wait, are you saying that he's the one who changed your heart? So, he's not connected with the Phantom Thieves, but is one himself? You're pulling my leg, aren't you? Are you serious? You really are a Phantom Thief? Oh, for crying out loud!
Sojiro!
So, basically, I've been sheltering a Phantom Thief for the last 6 months? And on top of that, Futaba's involved too. What the hell?
I want to find the culprit who killed my mom!
Wait, killed?
She was killed! Remember it now!
Stop this nonsense!
Why won't you believe me? Are you the same as everyone else? Didn't you know already? The way Mom died wasn't normal! Didn't you notice that her research was stolen by someone? Sojiro!
When she passed away, I did think it was odd. It was awfully fishy. But what could I do? All I was able to do was run from it all. And the outcome of that was me spending my retirement here. Also, the reason I took custody of you was me trying to selfishly atone for what happened to Wakaba. It's basically my fault that you got burdened with all this crap.
It's not your fault, Sojiro.
I acted all big, lectured, even yelled at you kids. And in the end, I'm the one being consoled. I'm hopeless and a laughingstock, aren't I?
I mean, why would you be at fault, Sojiro? It's obviously the one who killed Mom!
I see. Don't worry. Even if you are the real Phantom Thieves, I have no intention of reporting or kicking you out. I mean, who would believe such a story? Unless they catch you red-handed, it's impossible to explain that you're the Phantom Thieves. Let me just say one thing, though. Immediately back out of a fight that you can't win. Don't you get it? If, by chance, you pissed off the same guys that killed Wakaba, then they're not someone that kids like you can deal with. Listen to reason, all right? We're done talking about this. Let's eat. I'm so hungry because I raised my voice so much.
At least we avoided the worst-case scenario of being reported arbitrarily. Still, we should tell the others about what just happened. Oh, I'm tired.
O quê? Ele já sabe de tudo só por estar me zoando. Espera, você está bem? Ele não te denunciou nem nada? Nós provavelmente não estaremos falando com ele se ele não estivesse bem. Bem na cara da Anne, boa, Yusuke. Eu sentia que o chefe não era um cara comum.
Mas ele não disse pra você se entregar, não é? Eu acho que nesse caso
podemos considerar ele um aliado?
Eu estou mais curioso sobre o que ele disse a você.
Se refere ao que ele disse sobre o inimigo ser o mesmo que matou a mãe da Futaba?
Sim, ela foi morta por uma parada mental. O mesmo método usado pelo culpado que estamos perseguindo agora.
Espera um segundo. Você não disse que o chefe fugiu disso tudo? Significa que alguém estava tentando impedir que alguma informação saísse na mídia? Quem faria isso? Quem você acha que é o culpado? Ok, calma, que eu acho que pode ser o culpado. Provavelmente alguém do governo, um oficial do governo, um funcionário do governo. Mas espera, o Sojiro... Você não tá deixando sua imaginação correr muito solta? Mas isso faria todo sentido. Espera um segundo. Se você tiver certo, então a polícia também estaria trabalhando pra eles?
Bem, isso não é impossível. Isso tá indo longe demais pra eu sequer raciocinar.
Novidade, Anne. Nós podemos mesmo vencer isso. Nós vamos vencer isso, não importa o quê.
Tem razão, Futaba, mas... Vocês não acharam muito estranho o Sojiro ter dito que ele trabalhou pro governo e logo em seguida ter a opção de acusarmos alguém que trabalhou no governo? Ok, eu não sei. Esse jogo tá me deixando louco, mas eu tenho que fazer um corte agora.
É, por essa vocês não esperavam. Mas bem...
A Futaba tá no nosso quarto, estamos sozinhos com ela. O Mono também tá aqui, mas a gente ignora ele. Enfim, eu não vou fazer nada com você, Futaba, não se preocupe.
Já está tão tarde. O Sojourner está acordado. É um pouco esquisito isso.
Você pode dormir no sofá.
Espera, você não deveria dormir no sofá e deixar a Futaba dormir na cama? Ok, é verdade, eu deveria fazer isso. Então, você quer trocar a Futaba? Desculpa. Eu vou pra casa. O quê? Não! Não! Boa noite. Não, Futaba, não! Oh, fuck! Perdemos essa, droga! Tudo bem, não tem problema. A gente tem uma outra chance no Conference nível 9.
That concludes the speech given by Representative Masayoshi Shido, who may be forming a new party. We now resume our coverage of the Phantom Thieves, the suspects for Mr. Okumura's death and others. The police have designated the Phantom Thieves as the country's most wanted fugitives, and have decided to reward anyone with information leading to the capture of the Phantom Thieves. Look. Those who provide information will be offered a reward of 30 million yen. And considering the high amount, it shows how extraordinary the situation has become. Reward money will be supplied by the police and the families of the victims. Further...
If I report you to the police and they arrest you, I supposedly get 30 million yen for it. I hope you understand the situation you're in. Even people who didn't have an interest before will be on the lookout for the Phantom Thieves. And it'll happen every day, even at school. Why did this happen? This isn't about me. Well, how do I put this? I'm sorry I didn't realize it. It's also my responsibility that this happened. All I can do now is give you shelter. Just don't become desperate and do something reckless, all right? I won't sell you out. As long as you're here, there's nothing to worry about.
I feel bad about what we've done to the chief. I'm responsible too.
Did you see that reward? Perhaps we put too much pressure on them. With this, the Phantom Thieves have become public enemy number one. Exactly. That will be when their curtain falls.
Great!
Eu não consigo acreditar no quão grande é a recompensa. Nós devemos procurar os fetotivos nós mesmos. O Paquete disse que eles estariam na nossa escola, não é? É, mas... é melhor não. Tenho tido muitas paradas mentais por causa disso. Provavelmente será o nosso fim se xeretarmos esse assunto. Mas... são 30 milhões de ienes, cara. Apenas sonhe um pouco. É... eu faria muita coisa com só 1 milhão de ienes. Quanto é isso? 30 mil reais? Eu não sei. Enfim. E aí? Vocês viram as notícias? Eu já estava me preparando para isso. Ter um pedido de procurado para nós é um pouco esquisito. Eu não sei se vamos nos livrar dessa vez. Nós estamos com as costas contra as paredes. Discutir isso aqui não trará nada de bom. Vamos conversar mais pessoalmente. Ah, isso significa que eu vou ter mais coisa para legendar.
We're wanted now. And the reward's 30 million yen? What is this, a comic book? It feels so unrealistic, I can't help but laugh.
We're finally being treated as actual criminals.
I'm positive now. Remember all of those what-ifs I mentioned before? All of this was truly set up. How President Okumura ranked first, the fad before that, even Medjet. It was all to make the Phantom Thieves famous. On top of that, we were lured to target Okumura.
Yeah. The enemy likely planned to lay the blame on us from the start, after we gained popularity.
Then what about everything we've done until now? Are the people whose hearts we changed and thought were corrupt actually not?
No. Because of Yusuke and I, the Madarame and Kaneshiro cases were coincidental. Wasn't that the case with Kamoshida, too? Considering what happened with the rankings, only the previous target would have been used to lure us.
What a cheap trick to use.
Cheap? It's nothing of the sort. There's the fake Medjet and the site's altercation. They might have even engineered the fat around us. So much time and effort has been put into this. President Okumura probably wasn't their only target. Perhaps they intend to place all blame of past and future psychotic breakdowns on our group.
That's why I said we shouldn't jump into things so carelessly.
What, so this is my fault? Even you agreed to it in the end. And there was that thing with Haru at the time. How are we supposed to ignore that, huh?
I'm sorry. This was all because I one-sidedly decided that my father was a criminal. All I could think about was my fiancé. If I had only been able to cope with it more calmly... Haru...
It's not Haru's fault. I should have spoken up too when Principal Kobayakawa died.
Damn it! This is bullshit! God! Fuck!
Ryuji! Taking out your frustration on things doesn't help anyone!
Hey, what do you think? Why did we lose? What did we do wrong?
It's probably because we weren't acting like ourselves.
Agreed. At the time, we only cared about the opinion of the general public.
Yeah, that really is it. I was so caught up in making a name for ourselves. I'm such an idiot! I became a Phantom Thief because I hated those same kinds of adults!
To think we had begun clinging onto fame and a place to belong, but our eyes had become clouded.
We were meant to be the righteous Phantom Thieves, but we lost sight of our original cause. I'm so irritated with myself. Makoto...
Damn it! I know that we've been set up, and that I was a complete idiot too! But still, it's so damn frustrating! Of course I want to do something about this!
Yeah. We'll be in deep water at this rate. However, we have no idea who we're up against. And whether they're an individual or an organization.
Furthermore, they must be in a position of power. Or have powerful backers if they can go so far.
Are we really a match for this?
Should we end this now? I mean, things might get worse for everyone.
Hey, what should we do?
Yeah. Running away with our tails between our legs is exactly what they want. That's the same as dumping our aesthetics again, because we only care about our hides.
I see.
I take back what I just said. I can't let it end like this. Absolutely not like this!
Looks like we're settled on what we want to do. All that's left is how we go about it.
Sou eu. Puta, eu gritando mais cedo. Ter sido acusado e toda aquela recompensa me fez pensar que isso era tudo uma grande besteira. Eu perdi o controle, cara. Eu sinto muito. Tá tudo bem, Ryuji. Eu te entendo, cara. Tá tudo bem. Você também? Estou confuso, cara. Nós somos criminosos procurados agora. Talvez eu não tenha mudado desde o que aconteceu contra o Kamoshida, não é mesmo? Eu queria me tornar um Phantom Thief porque... eu achei que até uma pessoa como eu poderia ser um herói. Me deixou tão feliz saber que as pessoas dependiam da gente. Eu acho que eu deixei isso subir a cabeça. Eu achei que eu podia fazer qualquer coisa, se fosse pela justiça. Mas isso não me faz diferente dos nossos alvos. Eu chamava eles de sacos de lixo, mas... o pior dos sacos de lixo sou eu. Não consigo nem fazer uma piada com isso. Não se preocupa, Ryuji, você não precisa fazer piada nenhuma. Eu te entendo perfeitamente, cara. Nós vamos dar um jeito nisso, não se preocupa! Tá certo. Eu posso começar a mudar a partir de agora. Exatamente, Ryuji, mostra pra eles. Valeu, cara. Eu sinto como se eu pudesse pensar melhor agora. Ah, eu assustei a Haru e a Futaba, não foi? Eu vou pedir desculpa pra elas depois.
See ya.
Até mais! Ok, até mais, Ryuji. Até mais. Bom, ele de fato começou nisso tudo porque ele queria mudar... what the fuck? Me deixa em paz, pessoas. Eu sou youtuber, eu sei mais. Oh, eu recebi uma mensagem do Akechi. Ele quer juntar todos nós no Neblanc amanhã depois da escola. Que ele pensa que é pra ficar saindo por aí nos dando ordens? Futaba. Amanhã, assim, tão de repente... Isso foi diretamente logo após o anúncio. Deve ter algum motivo calculado para isso também. Nós vamos ficar bem, não é? Eu acho que sim, nós vamos dar um jeito, não se preocupa, nós sempre damos.
Sim, nós vamos superar isso. Juntos! Yeah! Poder da amizade! Além disso, eu não quero ninguém interrompendo mais a nossa paz. Vamos resolver isso com calma. Bem, vejo vocês amanhã.
Nós chegamos num momento crucial.
Mas não tem por que nos preocuparmos agora. Vamos apenas relaxar e esperar daqui amanhã.
É basicamente essa sua fala sempre, não é, Mona?
Ok.
Não podemos deixar as coisas terminarem aqui. Precisamos dar um jeito de descobrir quem está por trás de tudo isso. Falou e disse, Morgana, nós temos mesmo. A Cat já nos deu algumas pistas. Eu só não sei como que a gente vai descobrir a identidade do Black Mask, mas enfim, isso tá ficando cada vez melhor. Eu espero que vocês estejam gostando, sem cliffhanger dessa vez. Eu vou terminar esse episódio por aqui. Eu espero que vocês tenham gostado. Se gostarem, por favor, me ajudem com um like. Tá sendo um sacrifício traduzir tudo isso, mas tá valendo a pena. Então é isso, eu vejo vocês no próximo episódio de Persona 5.
An issue in which criminals do whatever they want under the name of justice cannot be left alone.